Thanks, Jamal. Our next guest got his start here in Chicago in Second City.
You've seen him on Queer as Folk, the Tonight Show, and VH1's I Love the 80s. Hal Sparks is back with us this morning. Good morning, Hal.
Hey, how are you?
I saw you come in out of the corner of my eye. I thought Josh Groban had come in. I love the new hair.
The locks are stunning, I have to admit. It's true. I had long hair up until I did Talk Soup, and I cut it right before I did it. And to me, this is what I normally look like. And this is, you have your own vision of yourself and what other people are used to. Yeah. And it's a little bit shocking. You grow your hair back out, and the whole world becomes your mother. Everyone goes, oh. Yeah. Oh, why do you have to? Oh, long hair, why? Like, yeah, all those horrible people in history with long hair, like Jesus and Da Vinci and the founding fathers and. But yeah, I'm the jerk. So, what, Manson and Ted Nugent screwed up for everybody? Oh, long hair, no. It used to mean you were smart. I don't know what the heck is going on. So that's how I look at it. And
good
a metalhead.
Well, it looks good.
Thank you. Now I can bang my head without looking stupid.
Yeah. Nobody is a better observer of pop culture and what's going on than you.
You've
got something on everybody right now. And
it's true.
Probably the number one thing that everyone's talking about now is this Ben Affleck and Jimmy Kimmel video.
Right. Yeah.
Which, we can't play exactly what you talk about, so be careful when you do. But,
indeed. I find the most ironic part about it is that they actually are a couple. I don't think people have noticed it. They think it's a big joke, and I don't know why that is. I mean, I'm proud of them for actually finally coming out about it. But Kimmel, he's been that way around town forever. He's been courting every male star that comes through there. I've only done the show once because of that. But Affleck never was on the show. They kept that pretty, it was a very Siegfried and Roy kind of a thing. But I'm, good for them.
Good for them.
We're
proud of them.
Yeah.
We know you, a lot of people know you from that I Love the 80s thing. It seems like the 80s have really made a revival in recent
Absolutely.
Years.
Absolutely.
It's all new again.
Yeah, it's funny how, the last 8 years have made us nostalgic for any other time in history, I think, pretty much. It's the last 8 years have been so bad, everybody's like, man, I missed the 70s. That was good music.
Right.
Or politics weren't so bad in the early 70s, were they? Nixon was a reasonable president, considering what we have now. I mean, really, woof. So I think that has a lot to do with it.
Sure.
The 80s had that kind of, goofy, lightheartedness about them that at the time we took very seriously.
Yeah.
I was just talking to somebody the other day. I was like, the amazing thing about Eddie Money was that he sang all of his songs with a straight face. And he went, I feel the thunder, I want the thunder. And you're like, he was serious.
Yeah.
He was not going, watch this. Making fun of Elvis. But they were serious about that. And you have to, there's an innocence we don't have anymore. Nobody could go into the studio and do that without nine guys in there going, Kathy Griffin will eat you alive. Nobody can have any fun anymore because there's 35 people on the internet. That was dumb. I didn't like it,
So I take it you've been following all the election coverage then, huh?
I have. I'm very excited about the thing. I think it's funny when people come up to me and they go, who do you think is going to win the election? And they, I got news for you. Nobody wins an election, ever. You get a job.
Yeah.
You don't get a medal and a $100,000 check.
Yeah.
You get to fix the sewers.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You get to keep traffic running on time, and you have to deal with war and gas prices.
Yeah.
That's why all the presidents, within 3 months, their hair goes white, and they're like, everybody's like, I won. I'm the president. And after that, they look like they've got progeria. They look like the Emperor in Star Wars.
Tech and the Power of Juju.
Yeah. It's my cartoon.
Scoop real quick,
Yeah, I have a cartoon on Nickelodeon that I voiced the character of Tack on. It's really great. It's 10:30 on Saturday mornings.
Cool. And at the Improv this weekend out in Schaumburg.
Indeed.
Whitfield Mall.
Thanks, Al.
True.
Thanks for having me.
Great to see you. Thanks.
Top stories coming up. The Cubs opener is in March this year.
Very exciting. Very exciting. Cold. But